Hello and welcome to this short breakdown video of my Blender rock generator. This project is using the Animation Nodes add-on. I will link the Animation Nodes add-on in the video description. You can download the Blender file and use it for your own project. The link is also in the video description. The whole rock generator is inspired by an 80 level article by Stephen Skidmore. When I saw this, I wanted to do something similar in Blender. So let's take a look at how it works. So here we have the complete node setup. On the left side I have all my inputs. In the middle part I have the whole rock generator. And then on the bottom part I have some sub-programs and scripts that I'm using to generate the rocks. First let's take a look at the input section of the node tree. The input section defines the inputs for things like the particles, the stones, it defines the amount of grass particles and stone particles that get scattered, it defines the offset between the different slices of the rock, it defines the rough and detail displacement. The rough displacement is applied on the base mesh, while the detail displacement later on is applied on the different slides or different slices of stone. In the input section, also the base mesh is defined. I will do all my example, or this whole video here, with the Suzanne base mesh. And also things like the subdivisions for the base mesh and the seed for the random height levels are defined inside of the input section. So let's start by taking a look at our base mesh. My base mesh here is the Suzanne head. I slightly modified it to have a watertight mesh. I removed the eyes of the Suzanne head and just closed them by collapsing the triangles. So let's make our node tree a bit bigger. And so let's now take a look at how it works. First, we're getting our input mesh, our Suzanne mesh. Then I'm distributing the slices based on the bounding box of the object. So I'm getting the maximum width and height and also the length. And I'm using these values to distribute my intersection meshes, which are simple cubes, inside of the bounding box of the mesh. So let's take a look at those intersection meshes. Currently I'm having 4 intersection meshes. They are defined in the divisions integer value in the input section. So let's take a look at them. And here we have our different intersection meshes. So maybe let's change the seed for now for fun. Takes a while to calculate. And as you can see, the random height levels, they changed slightly. Let's change the divisions. Now we have 2 divisions. Maybe let's use 5 divisions. Now that we have our divisions, let's take a look at how the Suzanne base mesh is modified. First, I'm copying it to another new mesh. This one is called base mesh here inside of the animation nodes container. And then I'm applying a subdivision modifier to the object. After the subdivision modifier, I'm applying a base displacement. This is the rough displacement that somehow breaks the silhouette of the base mesh a little bit. You can see it here. I'm using some procedural noise texture to displace my base mesh. Then I'm creating copies of the base mesh. I'm creating as many copies of the base mesh as I have intersection planes. So right now I'm creating 5 copies of the base mesh. I named those target. Basically the name is a bit wrong, but these target meshes then get modified by a subprogram which is called slice. You can already here see the result of the subprogram. So let's take a look at how this subprogram works. Basically it gets all the instanced base meshes and also all the intersection meshes, and it also gets the already created output meshes. I am creating as many output meshes as I have slices. The output meshes are the meshes that you will see in the end. And inside of the subprogram, I'm looping to all of those meshes. I'm first doing the boolean operation. You can see the boolean modifier here applied to the target mesh. Basically, as I told you before, the name is somehow wrong. Then I'm remeshing this mesh with a remesh modifier. And in the end, I'm applying a detail displacement to the mesh. After that, I'm copying everything onto the final output mesh. Let's take a look at the output meshes. So here everything has been copied onto the final output meshes, so they have no modifiers anymore. And those meshes get transformed based on the offset value that you can see here in the... Based on the offset value in the input section. So if I lower the offset value to 0, there's no offset at all. If I raise it to 2, we have an offset of 2. This offset is randomly, it's a random vector for every slice. And then finally, inside of the slice subprogram, I'm assigning the material to the instance meshes. So in my case, it's a simple rock material with some grass based on the world normal. So it's just a rock texture on the side, and on top I'm adding some grass texture, some moss texture. In the end of the subprogram, I'm outputting all my meshes into a new mesh list. I'm using this mesh list then inside of the grass and stones subprogram, so it just leaves the slice subprogram and directly goes into the grass and stones subprogram. So let's take a look at this grass and stones subprogram. The subprogram merges all the meshes together to one mesh and just puts it onto a new mesh which is called the particle base mesh. Let's take a look at the particle base mesh. Here we have the particle base mesh, which gets remeshed after it got merged to get one continuous mesh for the to scatter the particles. I'm then collapsing all of the modifiers on the object and store this whole mesh information on a new object which is called particles output. Let's take a look at this mesh. It is the mesh that you can see here. And then on the mesh, I'm adding two vertex groups to a script. One vertex group is used to define the stones, and the other vertex group is used to define the grass. The vertices get assigned to the vertex groups based on the dot product of the vertex normal to the up vector. Vertices get only assigned to the grass group if they are pointing upwards in a specific angle, while stones are only get assigned when the world normal points somehow to the side. So there are no stones scattered on top of the rocks. And after the vertex groups have been assigned, I'm executing two more scripts to assign the particles to the rocks. And then we basically have our end result. That's how the whole node tree or whole node setup works. Currently there are some problems or some things to keep in mind while using this rock generator. One thing is, if you change the modifier names, you need to turn off the auto execution completely. Otherwise, it will create a new modifier or particle system for every letter you type. Also, you need to keep in mind to clean up already existing modifiers after you change the name, because they don't get removed by my scripts. At least not at the moment. I guess I'm going to change this later on. Another thing is that the booleans might create some weird geometries if the displacement is too strong. Sometimes the slicing doesn't really work when the base displacement is too intense. As I said in the beginning, you can download the Blender file for free. The link is in the video description. I will not include the Quixel assets in the Blender file. You can download these Quixel assets by yourself. These are part of the free samples that Quixel provides. If you want some more information about this rock generator, you can just add a comment under this video. See you in the next video. Bye!